Hello, in today's video you will learn how it was possible to steal all your cookies and even more from mobile Firefox browser. The vulnerability was very creative and involved multiple steps. It was found and reported by Pedro Oliveira and he got $5,000 for it. Links to the blog post and his profile as always are in the description. Enjoy the video. When looking for mobile vulnerabilities with big impact, one of the things you need to check is how the application uses custom URIs. On Android, there are URIs with content protocol. They allow reading one application's file or data from the other one. An example of such URI looks like this. The first part is called content provider, and it indicates what application will be used to handle this URI. In this case, it will be mobile Firefox browser. And the second part is the path of a file that will be opened. And as you saw on the example, mobile Firefox browser allowed reading local files using those content URIs. But after opening such address, Firefox copied contents of this file into a temporary location and redirected user into this location, but not with the content protocol, but with a file protocol. It's simply used to read local files. And what's important, the name of the file in the temporary location remained unchanged. When defining those content URIs, the application can specify directories that a user can open, but Firefox used the following configuration. It means that the user can read any file that Firefox has access to. And among other configuration files inside Firefox directory, there is one that will be especially interesting for the attacker. It's cookies.sql, which contains all cookies for a specific profile. Stealing those files would allow the attacker to take over all the accounts to which he or she is currently logged in. But first, the attacker would have to read profile's .ini file, which would reveal the locations of cookie databases. So our goal will be stealing those files. And the most likely attack scenario will be that the victim visits our malicious website that contains the exploit. It's easily possible to create a website that opens a local file and alerts its content, but still the parent website has no access to those information. It's because same origin policy would block such attempts. It's a browser security mechanism that protects the websites from different domains to steal each other's data. In general, websites need to share the same domain in order to be able to access each other's data. But the question is, how do sites with file protocol obey same origin policy? Because they do not have any domains. Turns out, browsers are very strict about this and it's really hard to read others' file contents. But I'd like to point out the obvious fact that a file can access its own contents, or being more precise, contents of a file stored under the same path. And the browser wouldn't notice if under the same path would be a completely different file. And coming back to Firefox, all files are being copied into the same directory and their names are not being changed, so it's possible to have two files in different directories but with the same name, and once they are copied into the content URIs directory, the file will be overwritten. And that simple idea was worth $5,000 here. Let's see how the attack worked and explain the exploit. So we create a website and we assume that a victim visits it. This is its source code. Our goal at the moment is stealing the profile's .ini file from Firefox directory. The iframe will be executed first. It will download our file with a name profile's .ini onto the SD card. we'll take a look at contents of this file in a second. Then, Android intent is being used, and without getting into details, it's the same as we would use this content URI, but with additionally stated HTML content type. It will tell the browser to execute contents of this file, even though it has any extension. This will lead into Firefox trying to open our downloaded file with a content URI. And as you already know, first Firefox will copy this file into content URI directory. And it will be opened in the browser using file protocol. Let's now see its contents. First, we open an iframe with content URI, which points to the actual profile's .ini file that we want to steal. Then, Firefox copies this file into content URI directory, overwriting our profile's .ini file, but the old version is still being opened in the browser. Then, using JavaScript, we send a request to window location. It's a property that contains information about the current address. So it looks like the file would just get its own contents, which is of course allowed by same origin policy. But at the moment of this request, the file is no longer the same because it was overwritten. So we can access contents of this file and easily send it to our server, achieving our goal of stealing the profile's .ini file. It would reveal the locations of cookie databases, and we could steal those files exactly the same way. The whole process could be automated so that the exploit does not require any more user interaction than visiting the website. As mentioned before, the researcher was awarded $5,000 for this vulnerability. It was fixed shortly after being reported to the program, and this exploit no longer works. I think the way the vulnerability was exploited was really creative and oddly satisfying to me. If you feel like you've learned something from this video, leave a like and leave a subscription. Thanks for watching and goodbye.